Welcome to the Gear Garage. My name is Zach. This is my little internet show about whitewater stuff. And today I want to talk about stern frames. And this is stern frames from my point of view. I've used them a lot for whitewater guiding. And I have opinions and I have favorites, so I'm going to show you what I think. Before I do, I want to talk about stern frames you might buy somewhere else. And so typical stern frames, like the NRS stern frame, which is a good frame, matches the contour of the boat really nicely. And they're designed only for the stern. I'm not a big fan of those because they're not very versatile. They only work on the very back of the boat. If you put them in a two-thirds position, which I'll talk about later, or center mounted, they don't really work at all. So I'm not a big fan of those. This is the NRS Longhorn frame. This is a frame that I really like for its versatility. It works in the center, it works two-thirds back, and it works in the very stern all right. It's not the best frame for the stern, but it's adequate. And so you can see I'm sitting on it, works well here. The downside of these is there's little holes here because they're framed as a contour where you could have an arm get stuck, a leg get stuck. And so there is a little bit of danger by having this little square off the back. So that's something to consider when you're thinking about having a frame that doesn't exactly match the contour. But quickly for tying stern frames in, it's nice to have a lot of D-rings. A lot of modern boat designs I'm seeing don't have that many D-rings, making it really hard to tie in stern frames. And so this is a nice wing boat and it has D-rings everywhere, so I can tie on here, I can tie on here, I can tie on here in the back. And when I tie a stern frame in, you know, like all frames, I put the buckle through the ring. I personally, there's lots of ways to do this, but I wrap it around the frame once and go back to the buckle. And the reason I do it this way, I think having the frame, having some friction on the frame is nice. Some people tie a knot here, which I don't do because it's annoying to untie. But I like it so that if I'm in the boat and need to tighten it, I can grab the strap and tighten it from the seat. So I'm always thinking about that in case I need to tighten it. This has never happened to me where I need to tighten it, but in my mind, I like to be able to do that. And then if there's extra strap, of course, like you don't want strap flying around, so make a daisy chain or do something. Another great way to rig stern frames, especially in harder water, is to go down to the floor. You know, put a strap through the drain holes or through the lacing. And you know, there may be some durability issues, like that could ruin your floor. I've never seen it happen, but it's possible. But it really locks the frame down really well. So if I'm on a class 2-3 river, I'm kind of fine if the frame moves a little bit. But if I'm running really hard, steep stuff, I want this frame locked in. And I personally like going down to the floor. So that's rigging it in. This is the NRS Longhorn frame. Again, it's adequate as a stern frame. But I want to show you a couple other frames that I use and I like. So first of all, there's this custom frame that we had designed specifically to run stern mounted or for a lot of other things. And so I don't think you can buy these, but people do use them. And you can probably have one custom made. And it has like, you know, the frame is like pretty normal and it kind of goes up like this in the back so that it can sit on the stern. It actually fits pretty nicely. And you know, it fits better than that Longhorn. It's kind of made for the boat. And again, there are holes here. You could stick an arm or a leg or something, but they're smaller because of this contour. You know, it fits in the back here pretty well. The nice thing about this again is this can also be used in the center. And so it's a more versatile frame. My personal favorite frame, and it's probably because it's what I learned on. I feel like people are very partial to what they learned on, which I can't blame them. I'm that way. It's probably why I like pins and clips so much. I learned on pins and clips, so I'm partial to it. Now this frame is a little wide for this boat, so it's not gonna fit perfectly. But this is called a slant board. And the beauty of the slant board is it fits pretty well. There's only small holes here. But when you're running harder whitewater, you can slide up and down the frame so you can get your legs in the oar strokes. You can get down and just really yard on the frame. You have a lot more versatility. And also if you're getting thrown around a lot, if you're sitting on a seat, you have to get back to that seat. If you get tossed off the seat, you have to find that seat again. The slant board, you can come back to any position. You know, you come back to it anywhere you want to, up and down, it's just there. And so it's solid. I love this frame. The downside of slant boards for a lot of people is that your butt hurts. It's not super comfortable. So I've seen people pad them. I don't know, I just like eat a little bit more and have a bigger butt. That helps too. So if you have a bony butt, you may not like the slant board. but I'm a big fan. So this is stern mounting, I'm putting them all the way back. I also want to show you what it looks like to put them what I call two-thirds mounted, which I think is the most effective way to paddle hard rivers with paddlers. So here I want to talk about what I call like a two-thirds mount. I'm not sure if it even has a name, but here I am on the very stern. And the disadvantage of being on the very stern is that you're not, you turn better from the center. The closer you are to the center of the boat, the better the pivot is. Being in the way back of the boat, you can push and you can pull, but it's harder to pivot the boat. So from a rowing perspective, it's not awesome. And also, this is like a launch pad. If you go over a big drop or hit a huge wave, you can easily fall out the back. You can easily get launched from the back. And so this isn't as a guide an optimal spot. So this works for like easier rivers. But if you want to go do this on harder rivers, like, you know, the Futaleufú in Chile, they do this on Cherry Creek, on the Illinois Big Water, we do this a lot. What we'll do is move the frame forward into like a two-thirds position. And this is where this frame really shines. You can see this frame was almost designed for this boat to do this. And there's no holes. It's designed to be in the spot. Again, a stern frame could not move up like this. And the beauty is, like, you're protected. If you fall back, you land here. You have four paddlers in the front of a 14 boat. You can have six paddlers in a 16-foot boat. You're closer to the center, so you pivot better, and you're just sort of protected by the boat. So this is a very powerful method. If I want to run paddlers anywhere, this is my like method of choice for difficult rivers. So again, the reason I like stern frames that don't just sit in the stern is so I can move them here or I can center mount. So that's it for stern frames. If you have things to add, a lot of you out there use them a lot, probably have tips and tricks, please add them. If you have questions, as always, I'd love to hear them. I've done a lot of my guiding in stern frames like this. I really like this kind of rowing. So I'm happy to talk about it in the comments. And yeah, thanks for joining. See you next time.
Part three.